work after a while, so I ended up just bringing it up and just slowly working it off. And then I had an issue with the eye. And then I made another rookie mistake. When I re-grabbed there, vinyl touched the backing. It's not bad for the vinyl, it's just more of a pain because, look, I have to re-peel it all off. So you're going to take your rubbing alcohol on your towel, put a little bit of rubbing alcohol. I should have done this first, but what you want to do is just rub it really good into especially a rough surface. Any grooves, any corners, any of that stuff. Prep work, I would say, is the main part of applying vinyl. That's going to be whether it sticks or not. And you just dry it off real good because we don't really have time to take away it. And that'll ensure that you get all of the dirt out of there. Alright, then you're going to take your vinyl, line it up, holding the sticky side of everything down, and you're going to line it up exactly where you thought you wanted it before, make sure it still looks right without the white backing, and then just sit it down when you're ready. The reason why I don't squeegee it down is because this is really small, and it's on a rough surface, so if need be, I could just pick it back up because it's not really grabbed down. Now, I have an issue right here. I need to take my scalpel, or you can use a razor, and cut the clear transfer tape, not the vinyl, the clear transfer tape. And you can cut that to allow your E, well, my E in this case, to dip further into the crack. Well, the grab hand, without stretching and mangling the rest of everything. It's a very neat trick I learned. It allows you to just fit into all the corners and get the right coverage you need before you take this stuff off. Most people will take that letter off individually and stick it on. I like using transfer tape because it protects the vinyl. And then I'm going to notice that I have a little bubble here from the curve. Just messing with it to make sure that it's the right curve. And as you can see, it's at where my left hand finger is. So I cut in between the letters. Picked it up to get that bump out. And rubbed it all in. Made sure everything's good. Side of your squeegee, this is just my way of doing it, and it's rough. This is where you want to do the semi-hard rubbing to make sure that it fit into all of those extra little cracks and stuff. It's always, you can always do this after the fact, but I really like doing it with the transfer tape so your vinyl doesn't get all scored up and have it looking kind of messy when it's off. Not too many people pay that much attention, but I do. What you do is you peel this clear backing off very slowly, as you can see my A sticking. So all you do is you take your squeegee, run it back up, peel it off, and you can actually touch it a little bit to get it stuck. But once it's on there, run it over with the squeegee and then it's sealed. And same thing with the R, if you can see that. I wanted to make sure that I got that corner perfect so that it didn't pick up and stuff. And then just run it over just to make sure it's sealed. And you're done. It was that easy. I expanded it a little bit to show you my rookie mistakes. I don't want to hide the truth from you. So yeah. This is just another day. That's when I give you decals, when I send them to you. This is how you're going to apply them. It's not really hard. I did it just like I was a complete rookie and not honest at it. So you'll see my mistakes that are common mistakes for you guys. And if you need any help, I'd be more than happy to help you out. Just shoot me an email, call me, you know, my number's on my website. And get in contact with me. I do all kinds of custom decals, car wraps, everything you can imagine, and it all comes out flawlessly. So, and it's a quarter of the price of anywhere else you'll find. So definitely something to look into.